To you just a little bit. Well, I am showing you 8 guns today. I have 2 others that I'm not going to be showing you today because one of them is not at my house, and the other one I have to register some of the parts in order for it to be accessible.
A Beretta LR22.
nice gun. Don't come for me for my red dot, you guys. I know it's up too high. I didn't put it on here. This is how it came. Okay. I just have to move it. I haven't shot this gun yet, so I haven't had to move it yet. I'll do it eventually. Yeah, it's great. It's a great gun. I don't even know if it was that much, but I mean, not a great gun. It's a crappy, such a bad gun. And it has so much oil on it for some reason. I think I just haven't shot this in so long, but I've cleaned it since then. But like, there's literally like oil just all over the barrel. It's awful. It's awful. But yeah. And it's definitely an RP9, you guys. I should know that. It's an RP9, not an RPG. I don't even know what that is, but I know that it's not this gun. This is an RP9, Remington RP9. My 5.56. This is just an AR-556, Ruger AR-556. This is my M70. This is my Ruger AR-556, Ruger AR-556, 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 AR-556. So that just means that it's an AR and it shoots 5.56 rounds, which, I mean, kind of a boring name for a gun I wish they would call. It's like, I know that they have to do it for like safety reasons. You have to like call a gun what it is, but like, I wish that this was called like the I don't know what I would call it. The AR X. I'm losing it. Okay. I also know that this red dot is too far up, you guys. I know that. It needs to be back here. I know that. Because that doesn't, it's not very close. I know that. I know that. It's okay though. It'll get moved eventually, but I'm not gonna do it right now. That's not a priority, okay? I'm sure this isn't even sighted in. I bet you it's like 5 inches off. If I were to shoot it, it would be sighted at like 5 inches. It would be so bad. It'd be so bad. But this is my Ruger AR-556, 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 556, 556, 556, 556, Ruger AR-556, Ruger AR-556. Six. just like moving around my house, I literally keep a gun near me at all times because I, you know, you literally hear stories about like people just going into other people's houses and just stabbing them to death for no other reason than they were like on heroin or something. So, you know, I keep my doors locked. I keep strapped. I'm strapped. Most guns are black. You don't want them to be vibrant because then people can find them. You know, it's like, oh, I can hide a black gun under my bed, but I can't hide a neon orange gun under my bed. So that's why all my guns are black. Also, my favorite color is black. You can't tell. I love matte black. It's such a nice color, except for when that happens and you have a white wall. You have some white scuff marks on your black wall now because your gun is too mean. Your gun is mean. Look at, I scratch the paint by doing that. Like it leaves little like residue. Like it's like filing my nails for me. This one's dusty. I should probably clean this one. I hate cleaning my guns. It's such a task, you guys. I know you guys want me to, but I just, like, don't want to. I will eventually. Okay, I will. I promise. But I don't want it to be, like, me struggling the whole time. And so I'm gonna practice on one of my guns because I've never cleaned one of my big guns before. I've cleaned this gun. And I've cleaned my Remington, and my Glocks, but I haven't cleaned anything else, okay? I haven't shot them, so I don't need to clean them. It's just unnecessary to clean them because they're not dusty. I keep them in cases. I don't leave them out. I don't shoot them. They're fine. It's fine, guys. Pump, 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 H&R, pump, 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 H&R, pump, pump, H&R, 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 H&R. You guys, I'm not. It's too loud. I've tried it before. I have to cut him out. It's not happening. But this one has a really nice shock absorbing stock pad on it. That's, I really like how they built this stock because shotguns, I mean, like they're freaking rough, dude. Like a 12 gauge shotgun, they're rough. I usually shoot 20 gauge shotguns, but this one, whoo, this one amps me up. Okay. Shoot shotguns left-handed, so you know this arm isn't as strong as this arm, so I literally like, oh, this is a big boy. I have to like put that thing in there, and then this big inch thick rubber piece, and it has shock absorbing like channels in it. It helps so much when you're shooting a big 12 gauge shotgun, because the kick, I literally come home with bruises on my shoulder because this thing kicks so hard, and this is such a lifesaver. It's so nice to have that shock absorbing bump, stock bump on the back of this. It's so nice. I love this shotgun so much. It's a great, I recommend an H&R pump so I highly recommend it. H&R pump. And we have my little 26 Glock. This is my concealed carry. This is what I carry in my purse. This one is probably the one that needs to be cleaned the most, so maybe I will clean this one for you guys, because I mean, this one does get a little more dusty because it's in my purse all the time. But yeah, like, see all of the fixtures that can carry, that can like catch dirt at, and this one has also gotten really dirty, so this is probably the dirtiest gun I have, and I could probably go for a nice cleaning, like, honestly. Smallest gun that you can get that is like still powerful. It is a 9mm. It only has 6 rounds in it, but it's really small. This has 10 rounds in it and is a lot bigger. It's like the LCP is probably like literally like this big. It's so small, but I currently don't have that one right now. Zastava Arms M70. Zastava. Yes, I do gun ASMR now after I did this one, so stuff of arms. And I also learned a lot about guns from that video as well. I just thought that this was an AK-47. It's not. It's not at all. It's an M70, which I honestly thought that all guns that looked like this were AK-47s. Like, I just thought that that was, like, what you call them, like, you know, like a 9mm pistol. Works of engineering.